Well, we'll be getting to that clip of what was happening in Mombasa earlier today. My director will be getting that clip shortly. But we want now to cross over to our I&M studios, where we have Stephen Waweru, who is the business development manager at Resolution Insurance. And you might be wondering, why are we discussing insurance? Well, for you to travel out of the country, in some countries, you actually need to have travel insurance. And we shall be trying to demystify what this is all about. And let's now bring in Steve Waweru, joining us from our City Center studios. And many thanks for joining us, Steve. Perhaps let's just pick it up from what is the significance of this Tourism Day for you as players in this insurance sector?
Thank you, Abby. Just a slight correction. My name is Stanley, actually, not Steve. Now, the importance of to the industry is the fact that with our travel insurance, we are able to attract more tourists to come into the country with a guarantee that in the event of an emergency, they're able to be evacuated back to their home country, or in the event that they have to cut short their holidays in the country due to an emergency, we will be able to pay for their costs of any unutilized deposits for any accommodation that they will not have utilized, and also in the event that they have to purchase a new ticket to get back home.
Of course, looking at travel insurance, perhaps how big is it? Is it an area that insurance companies have been focusing attention on, or is it just one of those small items on your balance sheet?
Actually, for a couple of years ago, travel insurance was just a very small part of our business. But in the last few, say, 2 to 3 years ago, we have more underwriters coming on board, where about 10 years ago, we only had 3 underwriters who are doing travel insurance. Now we actually have almost 30 of them who are doing travel insurance. So it's grown considerably, and one of the factors that has made it grow so much is the fact that for some countries, it has become mandatory for you to have travel insurance before you travel to their country. And that has meant that a lot of people have no choice but to take it up as a requirement for their visa.
Stanley, sorry I got your name wrong the first time, but looking at people who are traveling, just break it down for us. Assuming today I want to travel to France, and what are sort of the amounts I might be required to pay if in the eventuality I want to travel insurance? And once I get to France, how can I be able to use this insurance? For instance, if I fall sick or if my belongings are robbed, how is it supposed to work, really?
Okay, actually, what happens is that as underwriters, as local underwriters, we work with international partners who assist in the event of an emergency. So ideally, if I go back to the requirement, if you go to the Schengen, if you're traveling to the Schengen states, which are actually in Europe, they require that you have a cover that has no less than 30,000 euros limit in coverage in medical expenses. But over and above that, we look at other risks that you're exposed to as a traveler. And as you said, there could be loss or theft of personal items. There could be a delay at the airport, or there could be cancellation of your flight. So travel insurance actually covers a lot more than just the medical requirement by the Schengen states. Now, what happens, for example, if you are in need of medical attention, we have an emergency number which operates 24 hours. We have a team that works 24 hours. They are on call. So on your policy document, you have a number that you would call, alert them where you are, the nature of the illness, mm-hmm. or if it is an accident,
yeah.
your location. Now, what happens is that we have agents on the ground, literally all over the world. So they will be able to guarantee payment of your bills to the hospital. And in the event that you have to stay in hospital for longer than your travel was supposed to be, They are also supposed to arrange for your travel back to your home.
All right.
So we not only cover your medical expenses, but we also make sure that you're comfortable enough, knowing that you will not have to purchase a new ticket, but that will be done by us to bring you back home.
Mm-hmm. And finally, Stanley, perhaps if you to look at, in brief, what trends should we expect in travel insurance, say, in the next 5 years?
Now, currently, and this is where Resolution is actually becoming a leader in this field. If you look at the market, a lot of the products were designed about 10 years ago, and they are not true reflection of the current market values of personal items or even expenses for medical bills. What has happened, Resolution having come into the market later, had the advantage to look at the expenses in the market, and our product actually responds to what you would to the expenses that you're looking at incurring. So we have a product that would cover you for medical expenses up to $1 million.
All right.
If you're looking at your personal items, we have a product that will cover your personal effects up to $5,000. And if you look at the other players in the market, the average is about $1,000, which literally means we're only covering, say, one item of whatever you're carrying to your trip or for your business trip or holiday trip.
All right. Of course, we are aware that other players do offer such products as well, not just Resolution. But many thanks, Stanley Waweru, for that incisive interview, just giving us a breakdown of what travel insurance is all about as Kenya marks the World Tourism Day. Well,